Tadias, everyone. This is Liban Ebisa with Tadias Magazine in New York. The following is an interview with Helen Amelga, a field representative at California State Senate and founder of the Ethiopian Democratic Club of Los Angeles. So thank you, Helen, for joining us. Please tell us about your work as a field representative at California State Senate. What are some of your responsibilities?
Awesome. Thank you so much for having me and for inviting me to have this dialogue. So yes, I work for the California State Senate as a field representative. So you can kind of think of us as the boots on the ground in our district. So the senator splits her time between our district office here in Los Angeles and then the Capitol in Sacramento. So we serve kind of community liaisons. So if there is a church, a school, a small business, in my area of district that I cover, it's my job to have a direct relationship with them and to support them. So if they have a question or need help with anything state related, they aren't cold calling our office. They know me, they know how to get a hold of us. So it's a lot of community work involved. And then also when the senator's in the district, we help staff support and write talking points as well.
Awesome. So do you you work for a specific senator or for the whole Senate?
I work for a specific senator. That's our rep here in Los Angeles, Senator Holly Mitchell, and she also covers Little Ethiopia.
Okay, great. So, but you're based in LA, not in Sacramento.
I'm based in her Los Angeles district office, correct.
Okay. So what inspired you to be interested in civic engagement? And can you tell us a bit about your background, where you were born, grew up, school, etc.?
Yeah. So I was born in Southern California in L.A., and then I've had the opportunity to move around a little bit. I lived in Addis for about 4 years in grade school. So I was born here, moved there. We moved back to L.A., and then I got to move to the East Coast in high school in Prince George's County, Maryland. We had a lot of family out there, so I got to experience different places. Something that was interesting for me was how people lived in the different places. And what I thought was interesting was a lot of that was dictated by policy and the laws of that land. So that kind of sparked my interest in government. So I majored in it. I ended up going into the field, and then that.
I see. So you majored in political science, or?
I did, yes.
I see.
In political science, I went to a small HBCU, Bowie State University, shout out the Bulldog, in Maryland.
In Maryland, nice. So what are some of the projects that you are working on at the moment as a field representative at the California State Senate?
Yeah, so our work has shifted just a little bit due to COVID. As I stated before, it was a lot of community work before, in-person community work. Now it's a bit more virtual. EDD and unemployment is under the state. So as I'm sure you know, in the state of California, we have very large unemployment rates due to COVID. So we're helping, serving as liaison between our constituents and the unemployment office. And we also we're about to go on recess, but we just finished our budget for the state of California. And my boss is chair of the budget committee. So if people have opinions, thoughts, concerns, things that they're advocating for, that goes through our district office. So we keep track of what folks support, oppose, what amendments they want, and then we get to relay that to our policy team in Sacramento.
I see. Is that like business loans and things like that for the community at the moment? What are some of...
So there are some loans. Some are through the state. Most are through local government. It's usually cities or counties that give more direct loans to the small businesses. And then there are federal loans as well. Many of them are not from the state. But when folks file for unemployment, that's directly through the state, through the unemployment office.
I see. And so you are also ahead of the Ethiopian Democratic Club of California. Can you share with us more about that?
Yeah. So through my work four state senators. So this is I've been with the state for 5 years now.
Mm-hmm.
So I was able to see up close how resources were allocated, how decisions were made. And then through my old boss, I was able to be appointed as a delegate to the California Democratic Party, which was also a great experience to see how the party operated. So once I had acquired that experience and knowledge, I realized just how many of us there are Ethiopian Americans in LA and how we were not organized politically and how much power we were leaving on the table. So me, along with a few of my friends, we started the Ethiopian Democratic Club of Los Angeles. So we're officially chartered under the Democratic Party. We have delegates in the state. The more members we have, the more delegates that we get. And our platform, educate, empower, engage. We want to make sure that folks here in LA locally are educated on how the voting system works, how the power is structured and distributed, and for us to actively be engaged in shaping policies, decisions, and elections that directly affect our lives here.
That's excellent. So how would you describe, in relation to that, the importance of voting? This is an election year. We're in a very important election year. So the importance of voting this year and engaging the democratic process, and particularly for those in our community or any other immigrant community, what's at stake in 2020?
Yeah, it is critically important. Something that's been encouraging is through the recent Black Lives Matter movement that's come out, I think people have really realized how much power we actually hold, and that the power really does lie with the people and their strength in numbers. And I hope that that energy is transferred and carried on into the presidential elections and local elections in November, because there really is power and strength in voting in numbers. And if we want to see changes in terms of policy, in terms of leadership and administration, it's essential that we register, our family and our friends, and that we show up and actually vote on election day. It's critical.
Yeah. And so, I mean, do you have plans to expand the Democratic Club, the Ethiopian Democratic Club of Los Angeles, into a more statewide or even, nationwide organization?
I think that definitely. So not just expanding the Democratic Club of Los Angeles, but trying to, ideally we would serve as a blueprint, right? So then other folks in different countries, I would love to see an Ethiopian Democratic Club of Oakland, of San Diego, of Washington, D.C., right? Because it's the local folks that know what their needs are, and it's really important for us to be active where we are. So I'd love to see that. But there's definitely, I think, a need for some type of, even if it's not democratic, some type of national Ethiopian-American civic engagement platform. And a number of us have had, talked to people in different cities on what that actually looks like. But definitely civic engagement is needed across the country.
Yes, absolutely. And I think, not everybody is necessarily going to be, Democrat or Republican, but just the importance of being engaged in general.
And that's something that we went back and forth on, was do we want to be a Democratic Club, a non-affiliated, just civic engagement? But we chose a Democratic Club because being chartered under the Democratic Party gives us a lot of power in terms of being able to vote and make decisions. So because of that, and because all of us who started it were self-identifying Democrats, we went the route of a Democratic Club. But there's a spectrum, and there's wiggle room in the party as well. So all are welcome.
Yes, great. So personally to you, what are some of the rewards and challenges of working as a field representative?
I would say getting to see the direct impact of my work, I think, is really amazing. Some folks who work in policy might not get to see that up close every day, but the fact that I am in the district office is I get to see the fruits of my labor, every day I get to work directly in the community and with the people who we serve, and that is extremely rewarding.
Great. And so, I mean, you're young, so what are your future plans? What would you like to see yourself doing in 5 or 10 years from now?
Yeah, so I don't have quote-unquote career goals per se, but I like to measure it based on my impact. So I would, in the next 5 to 10 years, like to see myself continuing to and to growing my impact and my service to my community in whatever way that might look. So just being able to continue to serve my community.
Okay. And what would you like to see, this country going in terms of advancing, you know, the issues that you care about?
Yeah, I would like to see what we're seeing now with this movement continuing, for people to be engaged, for people to really harness their voice and their power and to speak up. A lot of people might think that you have to be like a policy person or a politico to be involved, but you don't. Your experiences are enough. The work that you're doing in your life, it's not political, is enough, and that people really use those voices and are more involved. That's what I would like to see, is more engagement.
Engagement, okay. And that makes absolute sense. And, you know, in many ways, you're also a trailblazer. We don't have that many Ethiopian Americans who choose public engagement as a profession. If there are, you know, a few of them. So what's your advice to younger people who want to pursue public service, including even running for office in the future?
Yeah, we definitely want to see more of us in the field. Our goal as a political, as a Democratic, Ethiopian Democratic Club, is to have more electeds in office. So I would definitely say is to be confident in who they are, in their perspective, in their experiences. It's not just a degree that qualifies you, but it is the life that you have lived. It is being a student. It's being in this country and your experiences that qualifies you, and your voice has value, and to not be intimidated to step up. I would also advise them to reach out to folks like myself, to other young Ethiopian Americans and other young Black people in this country who are doing this work, and you would be surprised any responses you'll get to, you know, a LinkedIn email or a DM. Like, we're happy to mentor and to help and support young people grow into positions of power in this country.
Oh, yeah, fantastic. So is there anything else that you'd like to share with our audience before we end this interview?
Yeah, I would definitely like to emphasize the importance of the census. So for the first time ever, we're going to be able to not only fill in our race as Black African American, which we are, but to also be able to fill in our ethnicity or city of origin, or country of origin, rather. And for the first time, we're going to be able to have an accurate count of how many Ethiopian Americans there are in the United States, which means that we will have more funds and resources allocated to our community. That means that when we do register to vote or to get our driver's license at the DMV, we could have government documents translated into our native tongue, which I think would be great. But in addition to that, we will have money and resources flowing into our community, which I think is essential. So everyone should fill out their census, and again, not to be intimidated by government, by policy, and to really lean on your own life experiences to guide you and to feel confident enough to really participate in the democratic system here in the U.S.
Oh, great. Thank you, Helen. We're proud of you. We're proud of the work you're doing. And it's inspiring. It's important that the work that you do, especially in this election year. So we appreciate it. Is there a website, or how can people who want to, you know, join the club or reach out to you, you know, contact you?
Absolutely. We are Ethiopian Dem, D-E-M, Club LA dot org. And it's the same on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Ethiopian Dem Club. Follow along.
So I know that you lived in Ethiopia when you were a young girl. So you speak Amharic? Amharinya tunagarellish?
Ah, Amharinya chalalo, but I'm basmat maratin chalalo. Gana mambab yetamab kwinno.
Okay.
Kastabakas, gana. Kwankwayas afam.
Little Ethiopia stage ba Amharinya no, amitawaracho malet, no?
Ah, badam, ba Amharinya no, maara.
Okay, Helen. Thank you. Bye-bye. Ciao.
Ciao.